Okay, I previously shared a video regarding transformation. What is transformation? Transformation is the uptake of foreign DNA by bacterial cell. It can be natural or it can be artificial, right? Natural transformation frequency is very low. That's why in laboratory we used to make bacteria take up foreign DNA. Now, if we study the significance of transformation, it is immense. It is immense because it promotes the evolution of newer variety of bacteria, uptake of newer types or newer sequence of genomic sequence, and it helps the bacteria to ultimately evolve more and more. So the natural transformation, the frequency is very low. What happens when in a bacterial culture some bacterial cells die and their cell bursts and all the components of their cell like proteins and DNA and all, they are taken up by the fellow bacteria. So, and they actually take up the DNA from their neighboring cell. And what happens during the process of transformation that I have shared in the earlier video, that the double-stranded DNA binds and only the single strand enters into the cell, the other strand will be degraded. So that strand, that single strand has different effects within the bacterial cell that I will going to discuss later. But you have to remind one fact that only a very small number of cell in a bacterial population are basically can take up foreign DNA. That is, they are naturally competent to take up foreign DNA. Most of the cells are not. Okay, that this is a very important factor you have to make in your memory, that only a small portion of the total bacterial population can take up foreign DNA naturally. That's why in laboratory we make competent cell. We make the cells, most of the cells of a population, competent to take up foreign DNA. So that is, we make them competent, and that's why we make competent cells. Usually we perform chemical modifications of the cell wall of the bacterial cell. The chemically we make them competent by using calcium chloride, and other methods are there, and electroporation is another method by which we can deliberately or forcefully make them take up the foreign DNA. So these are the things we have to keep in our mind, that transformation is a very, very, very important process. And there are many complications while taking up the foreign DNA. So if we study that how bacterial cell take up foreign DNA, we should go into their cell wall structure or their kind of their barrier structure that resides outside their cell. In case of gram-positive bacteria, we know that gram-positive bacteria is characterized by well-built peptidoglycan cell wall and then the cytoplasmic membrane. There is no outer layer, outer membrane like gram-negative. So gram-positive bacteria, what they do is basically they form a channel in the cytoplasmic membrane, and that channel also continues to the peptidoglycan layer. And these channels are formed by some proteins. They are in the group of COM proteins, COM-EC, COM-A, COM-G, COM-FA, COM-EA. There are many, many proteins, and these COM proteins are arranged in operons. We have studied operons. Operons are gene systems that are in the control of, under the control of a specific promoter, and they are, their production, these genes expression are regulated coordinately, right? So these COM proteins, their genes are arranged in operons, and they are synthesized like in a high coordinated manner. Okay, so in case of gram-positive bacteria, these COM proteins form channels through their cytoplasmic membrane and the peptidoglycan layer. And this is the double-stranded DNA that take up from the environment, extracellular environment. And this double-stranded DNA is going into this kind of pore, and then there is a nucleus here. Here you can see is a nucleus which cleaves one strand into nucleotides, and only a single strand will pass into the inside of the cell. Once inside the cell, the single-stranded DNA becomes protected by single-stranded binding proteins. You remember single-stranded binding proteins? We have studied during studying replication. When after this single strand gets entry into the newer bacteria within the cell, it got protected by these single-stranded proteins, single-stranded binding proteins, or SSB. So this is a overview of DNA uptake by gram-positive bacteria. But this is much more complicated in case of gram-negative, because there exists an extra outer layer, that is the outer membrane, right? So this makes the process of transformation in case of gram-negative a little bit more complex, and here is the presence of, this is the process of transformation in gram-negative is complicated due to the presence of this outer membrane, because outer membrane is hydrophobic and it cannot pass the hydrophilic DNA, right? So there are proteins here. You can see the protein channels. A protein channel is there which makes the double-stranded DNA to pass through this, because in general, in usual condition, DNA is a hydrophilic molecule, it cannot pass through a hydrophobic one. So there is a protein channel in the outer membrane that is produced by the pilin proteins, and these pilin proteins, and there is also COM proteins, they form a channel mechanism by which the double-stranded DNA from the extracellular environment get passed into the cell. So the mechanism is quite similar between the gram-positive and gram-negative, but gram-negative is much more complex because of the presence of this outer membrane, and there has to be another mechanism to pass the DNA through the hydrophobic outer membrane, lipid-rich outer membrane. So there is extra arrangement of some extra proteins, that is the pilin proteins, and through which the DNA moves through the slender peptidoglycan layer and then the cytoplasmic membrane and then into the cell. And after getting into the cell, the single-stranded DNA is got protected by SSBs, just like the gram-positive bacteria. So we have to take into consideration that how sophisticated the process of transformation is, right? So in case of gram-negative bacteria, we studied that gram-positive bacteria, it is a bit simpler than gram-negative. And in case of gram-negative bacteria, this system This system is either secretion type 4 or secretion type 2. What is type 2 or type 4 secretion systems? Gram-negative bacteria have an elaborate mechanism or elaborate system to pass their proteins and DNAs and enzymes into the extracellular environment from their interior of the cell. Okay, so there are almost six types, I can't remember, secretion systems. So in this case, in case of transformation, two types of secretion systems are working, the type 2 and type 4. All of them are formed by proteins, and they used to form this type of structure, one in one channel in outer membrane, another in cytoplasmic membrane, just like the gram-positive bacteria, but a bit more complex. So the next point is, what is the fate of the single strand after getting into the cell? The single-stranded DNA is highly susceptible to degradation. So that's why it is rapidly covered by SSB proteins. Because as we know that a single-stranded DNA, if there is an orphan single-stranded DNA, it will get degraded by the nucleases that are within the cell. So they are protected by SSB proteins. And single-stranded DNA is also a substrate for binding of the RAK recombination protein. And this is a very important factor. This is a very important factor in, it serves one of the most important function of transformation. See, if the bacteria take up a foreign DNA, now it is in a single-stranded state. And there are many proteins of the recombination pathway that can exchange these single-stranded DNA with their existing chromosomal DNA, right? There will be recombination between these foreign DNA and the host cell chromosome, okay? As well as like it happens like a kind of exchange mechanism, right? So this single-stranded DNA might have some antibiotic resistance gene. It might have some toxin production gene, right? So it may confer some types of specific advantage to the host cell. So if the transformed DNA, that the single-stranded DNA that is entering into the cell, if this transformed DNA is highly similar in sequence to the DNA that is resident in the cell, the recombination proteins, RAK proteins, will mediate homologous recombination. Homologous means quite similar sequence, right? So, when exchange occur between two quite similar sequence, that is called homologous recombination. If recombination occurs between not so similar sequence, that is called non-homologous. Right, here if the foreign DNA is homologous to the resident DNA, it will going to mediate homologous recombination. Okay, if the donor DNA and the recipient DNA sequence differ slightly in this region, what will happen? The bacteria will after recombination, the bacteria will be a bit different, right? Because the foreign DNA was a bit different, and that after recombination, the host bacteria will become a bit different too because of the recombination, right? You will understand more about recombination after we study recombination chapter. So, what is the role of natural transformation? Because why it occurs? Without function, I have told earlier that in biological system, nothing is useless, right? So everything a bacteria does it serves some purpose. So role of natural transformations are there, very very pivotal roles. Number one nutrition. Nutrition, why? Because it can take up the foreign DNA and it may be degraded into the after getting into the host cell and produce nucleotides. Okay, and nucleotides can be used by the bacterial cell for their own metabolism. So this is a process of refreshment of their nutrients. Number two, repair. Repair, suppose the DNA of the resident cell, of the cell, the recipient cell, got some kind of damage due to something, some mutagen or some ray, some physical agent. And after getting a foreign DNA that is absolutely proper, with absolutely proper sequence, it can take up that foreign DNA and repair its own faulty DNA. So it can serve a very, very important role in repair. It has a very important role in nutrition, in repair, and that I have discussed in recombination too. So transformation is very important, and to understand the general mechanism of transformation can provide some information that how bacteria takes up foreign DNA and why they take up foreign DNA. So these are very important factors. Thank you.